Well, actually, it was a kind of a agreement between former Prime Minister of Israel, Benjamin Netanyahu, and also Defense Minister of Israel, Benny Gantz. Before the former government leave their office, they were saying that this parade should take place after the new government ceremony. These organizers were planning to do it before 4 days before the swearing-in ceremony, so they postponed it to today. I think this is going to be the first test of this new government, especially Naftali Bennett, who is a right-wing leader. When we look at who gave it go-ahead, the Minister of Internal Security, Omer Ben-Lev, he is the new Minister of Israel, taking care of this internal security issues. He's from a left-wing Labour Party, and he said that he was under impression that police was well prepared for it, and that all efforts were made to protect public security and also the delicate fabric of life. That's why he said that he gave a go ahead. And then they said that he completed a situation assessment with the heads of these security heads of Israel. And when we look at Naftali Bennett's side, he's a far right leader, and mostly far right Israelis will join this flag parade. They are mostly celebrating the occupation of East Jerusalem in 1967. That's why I think Naftali Bennett doesn't want to give a kind of reason to Benjamin Netanyahu to criticize him, and I think he is afraid of his voter base will criticize Naftali Bennett if he said that this march shouldn't take place. Well, Maria, I think it's likely, because when we look at the 10th of May, the situation was almost like this. Israeli police were inside Al-Aqsa compound, and Hamas said that we are sending a warning: if you do not take your police forces from Al-Aqsa compound, we will send our rockets. This is what they did. And now they are also sending some warnings to Israelis, and they were saying that this new march could be a fuse of explosion to defend Al-Aqsa and also Jerusalem. And I think Israel is also getting prepared for a new kind of hostilities between Gaza factions and also Israeli army inside in here. IDF Chief of Staff Aviv Kohavi said that they are well prepared for it and they are aware of it. He said that the situation in Palestinian sphere is volatile. They're all prepared for a renewed outbreak of fighting. And also the U.S. consulate, the U.S. embassy issued a statement, and they issued a travel warning for their citizens to come in here and occupy East Jerusalem. I think after 3 hours, we will see whether there will be a kind of provocation as Palestinians are expecting. And if there will be more right-wing Jews coming to Damascus Gate, this is the occupied East Jerusalem part, and mostly Muslims are living in this place. If they do a kind of provocation, most probably Palestinians can do some protest too. And it's up to Israeli police right now if they can join those Palestinians, and if they can join those efforts to separate those Palestinians and right-wing Israelis. We won't see a kind of demonstration as hostilities between Palestinians and Israelis. If they cannot manage this, unfortunately, another kind of round of fighting even between Hamas and Israeli army could happen, and that we can see a new outbreak of violence happening in occupied East Jerusalem.